quiet. If we have a kind of template permit to promote restoration on the landscape, so to move from the tens of acres to the thousands to the tens of thousands of acres of doing the kind of restoration work and keeping that in place over time, that we know in the face of climate change and in the face of the current condition of our forests, we really need to do. We have a suite of solutions that each of our tables is going to be looking at. So what can we do in degraded stream channels and wet meadows? What can we do to reduce sediment delivery, whether it's from fire or due to herd management? What can we do to manage across landscapes? What can we do to keep watersheds intact in order to promote resiliency in the face of the kinds of stressors that we know we have, and most particularly, for example, now fire? We know that it's not a question of when, not a question of if, it's a question of when and how. And so the kinds of actions that AB 2480 outlined and endorsed give these kinds of benefits. So this is clearly management for public trust benefit. What kind of permitting approach can we advance for that? Where we really tie the top of the watershed down to the reservoir. And what we'd like to see out of this is in those key reservoirs, the watersheds for the key reservoirs of the Shasta and the Oroville, which are the vast majority of utilized water in California in terms of the water system, that we put in place a program that ends up with 75 to 85% of those watersheds being dedicated for watershed management, compatible with timber harvest, compatible with other forest uses, and providing the kind of water security for the state that dams alone cannot provide, and particularly in the face of climate change.